Hi, I'm Chin Lu.
And I'm Sal, and this is our next make.
I love it when we find a project that is easy to make and uses a wide variety of maker skills.
There's woodworking and vinyl work, as well as sewing and button snaps. We think this project is a great way to learn new skills. Whether you're trying your hand at custom making something for the first time, or you're teaching someone in your life about the fun of making, we encourage you to stay tuned and we'll show you how this project came together.
First, we needed to figure out how big this lap desk should be. We got a quick idea by mocking up a surface with some cardboard. We used the size of a placemat for reference, and then roughed out a shape with a marker and a ruler. At this point, you could certainly refine the shape on the cardboard and use it as a template to trace onto a piece of wood. But we wanted to quickly test out some alternative shapes and figure out the size of the pillow underneath. So we made a digital model. I grabbed my iPad and launched SOLIDWORKS X-Design on a browser. Once logged in, I started up a new project and sketched a rectangle with the dimensions we settled on. Using the sketch fillet tool, I swiped my fingers across the corners to round them off. Then with the three-point arc and some trimming, I added a cutout so the desk is more comfortable when pushed up against someone's belly. After finishing the details on the desk, we laid out the size of the pillow. We needed to size it down to avoid interfering with the handles. This gave us a good starting point for the pillow size and the location of the button snaps.
At the sewing station, we flattened out some cozy fleece with fun graphics on it. When laying out the pattern, we made sure to reverse the fabric and orient the design properly. We added an inch to the overall width and height of the pattern so that we would have a half inch seam allowance. As we sewed the two sides together, we made sure to keep an opening about 2 inches wide so that we could flip the pillow inside out and have an opening to fill the pillow with stuffing. Before inverting the pillow though, we removed material at the corners to prevent any bunching up behavior when pushing the corner out.
Once the pillow is stuffed, it can be closed up with a slip stitch. This kind of stitch does a good job blending in with the machine sewn edge. You just fold both sides in and slip your needle under the material about an eighth inch, then do the same on the opposite side, staggering each stitch.
We wanted to create sturdy corners on the pillow for the buttons, so we repurposed some straps from an old bag. We cut, folded, and sewed up 4 triangular caps, then attached them to the pillow corners. Using our antique punch tool, we created an opening for the button. We placed the cap on the base holder and positioned the socket, then assembled the other side of the button snap with the punching tool and a hammer.
To add some personality to the desktops, we designed some custom graphics and cut them out of a sheet of metallic iron-on vinyl. In preparation for these to be applied, we needed to weed out the negative spaces. To get clean separations, we made sure to use a pricking tool and peeled the material at a very sharp angle.
Out in the shop, I started cutting the desktops on the CNC. If I were just making one of these, I would certainly cut the shape using a jigsaw or a bandsaw. But since we're making 3 desks, I let the router do all of the work. Going this route also let us experiment with the shape of the handles. We created a blind cut with a sloped wall along its inner edge. This smoothed out the opening and provided a nicer feel when the handle was gripped. To finish the woodworking, we routed off the tabs and sanded all the surfaces.
After cleaning off the dust with a tack cloth, we heated up the iron. Using a layer of parchment paper, we applied a 300-degree iron with pressure over the vinyl for roughly 40 seconds. It's not commonly known that you can apply iron-on vinyl to wood surfaces, but as long as the temperature and timing is right, the wood shouldn't scorch during the process. This technique really makes for a cool design, especially with a metallic vinyl material.
Once things cooled down, we applied multiple coats of polycrylic to both sides of the desk. Then we measured out and drilled pilot holes for the screws that would secure the other half of the button snap to the bottom of the desk.
The project was a great success. Our nieces and nephew really enjoyed them, and their parents appreciated the quick snap releases to allow for easy washing. We couldn't have asked for a better outcome.
We hope this project inspired you to make something or learn a new skill. If it did, let us know about it in the comments.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you on our next make.